Hey guys, it's Saru, and it's been a long time since I've talked about this game, Chrono Odyssey, and I do know that there was a brand new trailer and a lot of teasers and even a brand new website that came out ever since I created my last video, which was, I think, called something like What Happened to Chrono Odyssey. So I've been incredibly busy and I have not watched a single thing or even know anything of what's going on with this game or any game, and that's on purpose. Like, I can inform myself, but I'm doing it on purpose in order to get a first-hand reaction and share it with you guys. So this is exactly what I'm gonna do with this video. I'm going to put on the trailer, I'm gonna watch it with you guys, and from there, I'm gonna give you guys my reaction, my thoughts, and hopefully it's gonna be a good trailer. But from what I've heard, everyone seems to be hyped about it, so without wasting any more time, let's get right into it. So if you've already watched this trailer and you don't really want to watch it again, you can kind of skip it by going to one of the timestamps that's available in the description, or if you click on like somewhere on the player, I forgot where. And it should go directly into the reaction. I'm not going to be talking over the trailer itself. So let's see what it's all about.
Thank you.
So my first reaction when starting this video, because I'm watching it straight right now as I'm talking to you guys, is I thought it was really, really pretty. I am always wary about pretty graphics. I mean, yes, CGI can look really, really nice, especially when you're making trailers, but it doesn't necessarily translate into the final product. If you've played a lot of mobile games, you would kind of already know this. I did notice the combat had like no UI, which is really cool. I personally enjoy making trailers or watching trailers that has no UI, so you can kind of see the entire environment. However, I am a little bit worried whether or not the UI is going to be looking really nice, because in games that seem to be open world and kind of sandbox-ish, which this game does seem to be, it may be overcluttered, and I'm a little bit worried that we might get like a Black Desert kind of clone. I did really, really like the way the archer looked, but what really drew me was the class with the samurai. I think all the classes looked really, really cool so far, but I don't really know. I mean, this is kind of just seeing combat, sort of, with no UI, but I don't know if this is necessarily generated with actual players or like the dev team, or rather if it's just kind of all programmed. I did kind of get a little bit of a feeling of Dark Souls when they were fighting kind of this wolf character. I got a little feeling, I guess it was a little reminiscent of Mortal Shell with one of the characters that showed up right before this big dragon thing appeared. But overall, I think if the game does execute this really, really well, I think it could be a pretty good success, because I do know that they're planning for consoles and PC. But the problem is with Npixel, I do know that they're going more into the metaverse thing and they're going into a more mobile route, so I don't know how exactly they're going to achieve this and how exactly it affects this particular game. However, overall, the cinematic for the trailer itself looked absolutely gorgeous. I thought it was really cool. I thought the direction was really nice. The music was really nice. And there was a scene towards the end where the characters are walking towards this gate. It kind of reminded me a little bit of Throne and Liberty, which I have not watched any of the newer stuff. In particular, there was a cinematic in that game that had like a door that she touches it. But I think that's kind of like normal in Korean games, because I think I originally saw that in ArcheAge. Now, once they open the door, this is really funny because the inner domain, or I guess the dungeon, kind of looks like the album cover for my single My Confession. But other than that, yeah, I mean, I thought it looked really, really cool. I think if they execute it nicely, it could be a really, really fun MMO. And the fact that it's coming on PlayStation 5, Xbox Series X, and Steam, I think that gives everybody kind of like a really, really cool feeling. Hopefully it's going to be crossplay, and I don't really know. I'm going to go check the website right now, and let's see what it's all about. So I'm now on their website at chronoodyssey.com. And I really like their website. I like how they designed this, and I like the information that they're presenting here. At the very bottom, you can subscribe to get a chance for the future beta, which I always say, like, if you guys are interested in trying a beta, sometimes they're going to be NDA, sometimes not. Always sign up. You never know. You might get in, you might not get in, right? It doesn't really hurt to try. But yeah, the website doesn't really say all that much. You do get to learn a little tiny bit about the lore, and we do learn that I guess the world is called Cetera or Cetera. We also learn about the opposing powers or factions, I guess, which are the Guardians, the Void, the Broken, the Outcasts, and the World Movers, which quite frankly sounds like a lyric to me. But what got me a little interested is I do know that there is another game that's kind of messing with time. Actually, there's three now, I guess. So there's this one, Chrono Odyssey. I do know that Into the Echo also plays with time traveling and stuff like that. And Throne and Liberty seems to be similar in the sense of time traveling and trying to make sure that things are kind of like fixed in the past or something like that. I honestly can't remember. And I may be wrong because I did not write this at all as a script. I'm pretty sure Blue Protocol does kind of the same thing. And if I'm wrong, please let me know in the comments. But all in all, yeah, I'm pretty interested in the game. I'm not going to get too hyped up. I've kind of learned my lesson here. I'm cautiously hyped. So I am hyped for the product. I am hyped to see if the game does turn out to be good, but I'm not gonna like overexcite myself. But if there's any news that does come out, I'm gonna do my best to not give it to you guys like 4 months later and you know, try to share it with you guys as fast as I can. All right, guys, so if you're interested in Chrono Odyssey, let me know in the comments below. I'd like to know if you guys are gonna be playing and what platform. I think I may actually go back to PlayStation 5 for this MMO at least. I don't really know. Maybe I will play on PC, but I don't really know. Let me know in the comments below and we'll talk about that. All right, guys, thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe and click that adorable f***ing bell to know when I upload a brand new video. And don't forget to come join my Discord if you wanna chat and hang out. Much love, and as always, till next time, friends.